So far in microservices architecture series, while converting monolithic application into microservices architecture, we have talked about only business logic. We haven't talked much about the database and the data that was being stored in a single database. How is that going to be divided across multiple services? This video and upcoming video, we are going to talk about that. So let's go ahead and get started. First, we are going to see what are the challenges that we are facing with the microservices architecture, and there are unique requirements for each microservices. What are those? That services must be loosely coupled. Why so? So that they can be developed, deployed, scaled independently. So they are not interdependent. So these are the facilities that we need when we are following the microservices architecture. And there is also unique requirement for each service. There is going to be different data and different storage type for each microservice that we are going to have. So let's go ahead and talk about the different patterns that we have. So first, we have database per service. It means the different microservices that we have, product management, order management, account management, they are going to have different database of their own. So each microservice will be associated with their separate database. So let's go ahead and analyze the advantages, drawbacks, and challenges with this strategy. First is the benefits. They are loosely coupled and you are free to choose any database type that you want for each microservice. You can go for the relational database, you can go for the MongoDB, you can go for the Cassandra database as per requirement of the microservice. And when we are saying that database per service, it is not necessarily that you have to install a different database server for each microservices. There are different patterns that we can follow to use the same database server for each microservices. These are the patterns. So first is the private tables per service. If we have same database, it is a database server, right? And it is being shared between server 1 and server 2. But we can have private tables per service. We can create the tables which are private to service 1, and we can create the tables which are private to service 2. So service 2 is not going to know that there are more tables than it has access to. So this way also we can separate the data within the same database. And the second strategy we can follow, that schema per service. So we can create different schema for different services. This is the most followed strategy. And the third one is the normal one, that install database server for each service. Until unless you have a specific requirement that you have to do it and there are no other options, you have to go it. Otherwise, it is best advice that you go for the schema per service or private tables per service. Now let's talk about some challenges with the database service that we have. So first is that query needs join over multiple database. When user is requesting for some specific data, it is a real-time requirement that you need to have join of those table which are associated with the different microservices. So you have to take care of this. And second is about the transaction. When earlier we had a single database server in monolithic architecture, it was easy to join the tables as well as manage the transaction. But when we are in the microservices architecture, there are unique requirements and there are unique challenges like these one. So how to solve these challenges? Let's see that. First, see the database. This is the microservice architecture, right? So each service has each database, a separate database. So see how we can solve these challenges. First challenge that needs the query, that only concerned about the queries. It is asking for some data that needs join over multiple tables. So these are the some strategies that we can follow. First one is the CQRS. Then we have event sourcing. Then we have API compositions. These are the some patterns that we can use to solve this challenge very easily and effectively. And when we talk about the transactions, Saga pattern comes into picture, which resolves the concern about transactions very effectively. So these concepts, CQRS, event sourcing, API composition, Saga pattern, we are going to talk about in detail in upcoming videos. So it's all about the database per service. Let's talk about when we have a single database which is shared among multiple microservices. When this scenario comes into picture, when we have brownfield project, strategy that we have earlier talked about is very simple. You have separate data. You have separate database for each microservices. But there are certain scenarios when you are converting your monolithic application into microservice architecture, that it is not possible. It is not possible to divide the database like when we have service 1 and service 2. And this service 1 is associated with the order, and this one is associated with the customer. And there is some data associated with these tables in such a way that it is not possible to separate. So we can have single database which is being shared between these two services. This is also possible, but we also have to restrict that there should not be more than 2-3 services sharing same database. It should be an initial strategy to share the database among microservices, but in future, in long term, we should have plan to segregate this database even itself. Let's see the real time example. Let's see one real time example that we have this order table and we have this customer table. And this order table has data about ID, customer ID and status about the order and what are the sum total to pay. This is customer table which has this customer detail about this one and the ID, and this ID is related. So when we have segregated the business logic about order microservice and customer microservice, we can do that, but we have to share this database. So these are the scenarios that come. There is no harm in doing so initially, but future plans should be to segregate this one. Why we go for this share DB per service? There are some advantages of this one. So let's analyze that. So there is this familiar structure that these are the tables that are being used for the same logic, and we can share that database and it is simpler to operate. So these are the benefits, and at the same time, there are some challenges as well. So there is tight coupling, runtime coupling, there is development time coupling, because when you were working on a service one and which had some data, and service one and service two which is also sharing same database, so you have to make some coordination. There is like microservices architecture had some characteristics. There has to be some loose coupling. There has to be loose coupling and there is no tight coupling. But here we are making a very tight coupling for the data, which is very critical. This is the tight coupling. So it might not satisfy the storage and access requirement for all services. So yeah, it is possible. So now you do not have any flexibility to use different database type for this S1 and S2. Because you have to use the shared one. So whatever it is, whether relational, whether Mongo, whether Cassandra, you both of these services have to use this one. Because of these drawbacks, it is advised to go for the separate database for each microservice. That's all about these two patterns, when we are sharing database for microservices and when we have individual database for each microservices. So in further videos, we are going to focus on the first strategy, that is individual database for each microservice. And there were certain challenges that we followed, and we are going to solve that. And what we are going to see the patterns that are there to solve those ones. So first among them, we are going to talk about the CQRS. It's very important and very easy to understand. Before leaving the channel, if you like the content and want me to make more such videos, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe the channel. It really motivates me to put more efforts in making these videos. I'll see you in the next video with the CQRS. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.